Hello, NEET aspirants. Let us discuss NEET 2020 conducted by NTA in September. Let us discuss the code G5. All questions are from NCERT textbook only as far as zoology is concerned. Second question is from zoology. Bilaterally symmetrical and acoelomate animals are exemplified by Platyhelminthes. See, this is from page number 51, NCERT, plus 1, C. Bilaterally symmetrical triploblastic and acoelomate animals are Platyhelminthes. Yes. And next, the second question from zoology, serial number 3. Match the following columns and select the correct options. Gregarious polyphagous pest is locusta. And adult with radial symmetry and larvae with bilateral symmetry, Asterias. Buklungs, Scorpion. Bioluminescence, Tinogram. So, this is exactly from the NCERT textbook. Tinoplana bioluminescence. Okay, and next locusta gregarious pest, Buklungs scorpion. Okay, Echinodermata, see, adult are radially symmetrical and larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. So this is exactly from the NCERT textbook only. Now coming to the third question, fifth serial number, the QRS complex in a standard ECG represents depolarization of ventricles, that is page number 286. Let us see. See, the QRS complex represents the depolarization of the ventricles, exactly from the NCERT textbook. Now coming to the fourth question, match the following columns and select the correct option. Floating ribs do not connect with the sternum. Acromion, clavicle. So it is the process which will be connected to the clavicle. Clavicle will be connected, acromion of the scapula. And next, scapula is located between second and seventh ribs. And next, glenoid cavity, that is where head of the humerus fits. So this is exactly, this is also from the NCERT book only. Coming to the 310, page number 310, you see. Clavicle, acromion, and next scapula, it has a elevated ridge called acromion. And next, coming to the acromion, and next glenoid cavity, it articulates with the head of the humerus. See, exactly from the NCERT textbook only. It is situated between the second and seventh ribs. Scapula is situated between the second and seventh ribs. So, and floating ribs will not be connected to the last two pairs, 11th and 12th, are not connected ventrally and are therefore called floating ribs. So, this is exactly from the NCERT textbook. And coming to the next question, fifth question of zoology, serial number 9, in code G5. Coming to match the following columns, select the correct option. Pituitary gland, diabetes insipidus. Thyroid gland, Graves' disease. Adrenal gland, Addison's disease. Pancreas, diabetes mellitus. This is also exactly from the NCERT textbook. Coming to the 334-335 pages. See, diabetes insipidus, pituitary gland. Graves' disease, thyroid gland. Adrenal gland, Addison's disease. See, exactly from the NCERT textbook. Diabetes mellitus, pancreas. So, nothing outside the textbook. With this, we finished 5 questions, no? And now, let us pass on to the 6th question. If the head of the cockroach is removed, it may live for few days because the cockroach does not have nervous system. No, the head holds a small portion of a nervous system while the rest is situated along the ventral part of its body. It is exactly on the base 114. The head holds a bit of nervous system while the rest is situated along the ventral part of the body. Now you understand that if the head of the cockroach is cut off, it will live for as long as 1 week. So exactly from the NCERT. And next, select the correct events that occur during the inspiration. Contraction of diaphragm, contraction of external intercostal muscles during inspiration. That is in 270, the page number 270, we will see the answer. 270. See, inspiration is initiated by contraction of diaphragm. The contraction of external intercostal muscles lifts up the ribs. So, this is exactly from NCERT. And now, coming to the eighth question, that is, by which method was a new breed, Hisardale, of sheep formed by using Bekaneer ewes and Merino rams? So here, crossbreeding is the correct answer. Now, in second year NCERT textbook, 168, page number 168, you will have the answer. 168. See, Hisardale is a new breed of sheep developed in Punjab by crossbreeding Bekaneer ewes and Merino rams. See, that is exactly from the NCERT textbook. And now, next question, match the following diseases with the causative organism and select the correct option. Human health and disorders. So, in second year, page number 146, see, typhoid, salmonella, pneumonia, haemophilus, filariasis, Wokaria, malaria, plasmodium. Page number 149. Second year, page number 149. See. Elephantiasis or filariasis, Wokaria. And next, pneumonia, haemophilus. And next, typhoid, salmonella, typhoid. Okay, so malaria, plasmodium. That's it, exactly from the textbook. Now coming to the 10th question, పేజ్ నెంబర్ 127 ఫ్రమ్ హిస్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్స్ ఎస్ఎల్ మిల్లర్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ అమైనో యాసిడ్స్ బై మిక్సింగ్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్ ఇన్ ఎ క్లోజ్డ్ ఫ్లాస్క్ ఇన్ ఎ క్లోజ్డ్ ఫ్లాస్క్ సో హియర్ మీథేన్ హైడ్రోజన్ అమోనియా అండ్ వాటర్ వేపర్ ఎట్ 800 డిగ్రీస్ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ సో 127 127 you will find the answer exactly see here SL Miller in C he created electric charge in a closed flask SL Miller of amino acids sorry methane hydrogen ammonia and water vapor at 800 degree centigrade so this is about 10 questions of zoology we have covered next I will explain the remaining questions in next video if you like it subscribe my channel and share it with your friends all the best